G'day Radiologic DJ lovers. Today we're going to take a look at voice tracking or robo-jocking, pre-recorded shifts, or even just pre-recorded spots inside of Radiologic. Now, Radiologic DJ has made this very simple. What you will need to do is find yourself an external editor. You may want to check this one out here because it is quite simple and it is open source and free. Ocenaudio, and I'll leave a link for that in the description so you can pick that up and try this out for yourself. At least that way you can compare it. How you're going to get audio into your software while you're on air or not on air, I'll leave that up to your own situation. So some desks will allow you to put the microphone into queue and it'll be able to record but not go through to air. So this station isn't running at this point. So you may have to find a different way around getting your audio in while you're still on air. So if you have a look at the Radiologic DJ screen in the bottom left-hand corner, this one's already set up with Ocenaudio. But if you just click on plus record or add record with, and this is what's going to record our voice tracks. Now you're going to select the program that you want. So once you've downloaded Ocenaudio or an editor of your choice, and it's better to do one that doesn't utilize a session file. You want it just to record tracks and save them. That's all it does. And that's why probably Ocenaudio is pretty good for that. So you want to go into add record with Ocenaudio in this case, or command R. Now, if you put this, let's just pick the second track here. And if I push that button there, it will open up if it's not already open, which is another possibility. It'll open it for you anyway. And there's the track. So if you look up here, so 21 and the time, so that's the date. And it will also add that over to here on the Ocenaudio track. So whatever we record over here, Radiologic DJ will actually pick that up. It'll pick up the new time and everything that you've put in it, which is very cool. So let's take a look at this. So for example, you want to sell between songs. We can give that a crack. We've got a song here and a song here. We want to talk in between them. We can come over here. We can push our record button and that will record the file. And then from there, we can either edit it if we want to or use the properties function inside of Radiologic DJ to do that for us. So maybe we'll give it a go. Hit the record button like that. You've just heard Rich Goyette from his 2013 album, Simple Reminders, the title track. Coming up, we've got some Craig Faraway, some 80s beats. Thanks for hanging out with the Optimod on the mix. And we can push stop. Now, we can just scroll that back out, and if we want to, we know that's me talking over here. All right, so we don't need all that. So what we can actually do is just highlight what we want. We know we want that bit there and that bit there. And there's a couple of different ways of doing that. There is the delete function, but if I just go trim, it'll just knock everything else out of the way, which is kind of handy, really. So let's play that back. You've just heard Rich Goyette from his 2013 album, Simple Reminders, the title track. Coming up, we've got some Craig Faraway, some 80s beats. Thanks for hanging out with the Optimod on the mix. There we go. So there's your voice track is recorded. Now, if we want to add anything else to that, you can come up to this section here. You go right up to the top and go to Effects. And we can come down to VSTs or audio units, depending on what you've got installed. I'll come down here to Thomas Month and I'll go to Loud Max. Now, it actually comes up with the last setting that I've already saved. You can go in there and save presets and you can move this around. So if I just put this back to where it was originally with no compression on it at all. You've just heard Rich Goyette from his 2013 album, Simple Reminders, the title track. And if we just put on a little bit of compression there and just drop the overall volume just so it doesn't hit over zero and audition that. You've just heard Rich Goyette from his 2013 album, Simple Reminders, the title track. And if you want to bypass that and listen to it again. You've just heard Rich Goyette from his 2013 album. That's what it was originally. So we can leave that in there. And then we just go apply, and that will apply that in real time. Okay. So apart from this, this is very easy. Now, if you want to, you can just go Command S for save, or you can go up to the file menu and go save. Now watch what happens over here in Radiologic DJ. It has now changed the time of that arbitrary number that was given to that little audio snippet of nothing before to now the 10.7 seconds. So it's 10.7 seconds our track over here, and it's 10.7 seconds over here. Now if you want to go one step further and you want to utilize the ramp feature inside of Radiologic DJ, just click the voiceover player. So that way that track will then go to the voiceover and whatever you've got set up in your preferences for ducking, it will then duck this voiceover over the intro of the next track, and that's got a ramp of 25.2 seconds, which is easy. And what we will try to do is we'll go to edit. And metadata works well. So if we go to metadata, we can give this a song title. So we can call this, we can go along with the track. So you don't have to do this, but in case you're moving things around inside of Radiologik DJ, you go, oh, which one did I record and which one does it actually relate to? So if you end up having to move some spots here and there. So we'll just call this one your ever beating heart intro. And what we can do is if we want to know who that artist is, or in this case, it's me. So I'll just put who's the voiceover. That makes it easy. It's easy to find. And then we save that file. So that's just the metadata. That's just the data underneath the audio track. So if we go Control S, would you like to proceed? Yes, let's do that. And now over here in Radiologik DJ, it says the artist is me. So in other words, the voiceover on air, and then your ever beating heart intro, which is for that song. So it's really kind of simple. There's different things you can do inside of Ocean Audio if you want to muck around and have a little play around in there. But let's just give you a bit of an idea of how this sounds. So we'll set this going. We won't listen to all the tracks, and we'll give it a bit of a play, see what happens. You've just heard Rich Goyette from his 2013 album, Simple Reminders, the title track. Coming up, we've got some Craig Faraway, some 80s beats. Thanks for hanging out with the Optimod on The Mix. So there we go, a voice tracking session with Radiologik DJ made really simple with Ocean Audio, and being able to utilize that metadata, I think, is the key to being able to keep things categorized nicely for you. Again, if you want to use that file again, you can just right-click, go Save As, and put that into your folder, whichever you which one you want to use it, if it's going to be your intros and outros, things like that. And of course, just put that dash one so Radiologik DJ knows what it's all about. And just remember, as you record them, just select that voiceover player, dash, 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 all the way down, and then you'll know which ones only, obviously, your voiceovers, your voice tracks, and that way Radiologik DJ will run it over the ramps for you, as long as you've got your ramp time set. Pretty easy and very simple, really. So if we want to do another one, just watch what happens. Again, select the track after where you want it to go. Push Add, Record. There we go. And you're ready to go for your next one. Just recording, ready to go, enabled, stop. Piece of cake. Hope that's made it easy for you. Hope your voice tracking sessions go really well for your station. And maybe we'll catch you on another video soon. Cheers.